find out this. Look, John.
Hi, Kanan.
What up? What are we doing today?
We are going for an adventure. I'm so fancy. You
already know I'm in the back. Helicopter!
If it doesn't search, then try a quarter.
John going pee.
There it is.
Hashtag John going pee.
Kanan, hashtag shut up.
Hashtag.
I got it peeing on my car.
Look at all the vehicles. Oh no. He's not even looking around. Alligators are around here. Probably like a bit one.
Alligators?
He can't hear you.
They're not even peeing on my car. Are there any gators out there? How can he still not hear me?
I don't know, Mom. How can he not hear me?
Just remember that when we stop, I have to go pee.
Now it's gonna smell bad.
It's not like windshield.
Airplane.
Got that one.
Got it?
Yeah.
Water. That's where the beach must be. Going on a little tour. All around here. So we're going to the entrance, handing my ticket. Look at that. All of it. No space station. Palm trees, warm out, sunny, humid, dying from heat, no, not kidding. Space station everywhere. NASA. Angry Birds. Every person's favorite. So we're on the bus now.
This is NASA's Kennedy Space Center.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing.
From countless robotic
building by volume. The inside of that building encompasses a massive 129,428,000 cubic feet. In just a few minutes, we'll be going around and we'll be seeing the east-facing doors. Those doors are 456 feet tall. Now, when I bring you out to Saturn V, you're going to see that rocket is 363 feet tall. Now, when we were sending our men to the moon, and those rockets were in that building on their mounting, launching platforms, there was only 6 feet of clearance between the top of the rocket and the top of that door. That's how big those rockets are. Now, one of the other reasons that building is built as large as it is because back in the 60s and 70s, there was talk of colonizing the moon. Actually having people live up there. Well, they wanted to get two or three Saturn V's in there at any one time and get to be within feet of it. Very exciting, not normally out here. Now, if you look right straight ahead of the bus here at 1 o'clock, you're gonna see four big towers. That's Launch Pad 40 down at 1 o'clock. When bus 14 clears straight ahead, you'll see four more towers. That's Launch Pad 41. That whole area to the right is Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. We'll talk about that more in a minute. It's the only thing standing in your way. You're so close to what's real. If you only looking at 39A exactly the way it was when we last lifted Atlantis in 2011. Today as well. Again, not a normal bus tour. Well, ladies and gentlemen, right past this stop sign, on the other side of the railroad tracks, is the beautiful Atlantic Ocean. I bring this up for a couple reasons. Number one, 39A and B were just on the other side of those sea oats right there. But a lot of people always ask the tour escorts, why did NASA choose Florida? Why are we here and not Kansas or Michigan or Pennsylvania? Well, ladies and gentlemen, there's many reasons. I'll give you two. Number one, please look out to the right of the bus. No one lives there. So if we have a problem with a launch, we don't have to worry about the general population. But the main reason that we have launches here in Florida is you may or may not know that the Earth rotates on its axis. The closer you are to the equator, the faster the Earth rotates. Right now, if you were to stand on that ground, we're going at 900 miles an hour. That's how fast the Earth is rotating. So NASA actually uses the rotation of the Earth to send our rockets into orbit to use less fuel. And that's why we're in Florida. Well, speaking of fuel, to the left, this big white orb holds 900,000 gallons of liquid hydrogen. There's another orb that is in back of that that holds 850,000 gallons of liquid oxygen. Together, the space shuttle required 500,000 gallons to reach its orbit. Well, ladies and gentlemen, why are we dismantling 39A? 2 years ago, 39B was identical to 39A. Identical. But they've come in and leveled it, put up the three towers, three lightning arresters, run all the fiber optic cables. All right, ladies and gentlemen, time for me to debunk a great myth out here at 39B. A lot of controversy, a lot of arguing. I'm here to set the record straight. Contrary to popular belief, these two green buggies next to this wall are not moon buggies. They're not moon buggies. They're golf carts. You will, however, see a moon buggy out of the Saturn V rocket set. And again, ladies and gentlemen, that's not a normal bus tour when we're weaving in and out of parking lots. Ladies and gentlemen, there's about 11 to 12 foot alligator right there. See him to the left? That's his head. That's Wally Gator. That is one big alligator right there. Please stay in your seats. That's a big alligator. Again, not a normal bus tour. You don't normally get out here. This crawler way across the road, ladies and gentlemen, is brand new. For the first time in 50 years, they redid it. This crawler way is 7 feet thick. And it's made of clay, asphalt, sand, and the very top of it is Tennessee River gravel. There's two reasons for the river gravel. Number one, rains we need drainage. And number two, the amount of friction on the bottom of the crawler tracks, the river gravel helps reduce the amount of friction. 1,500 miles an hour. I'll repeat that number. 17,500 miles an hour. Our beautiful Earth is around 25,000 miles in circumference. So that means it only takes the ISS 90 minutes to go around our Earth one time. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you are truly looking at a piece of American history up here in the crawler. It is this very crawler right here that took the Apollo Saturn V out to the launch pad over 45 years ago and took our men to the moon. It's been modified, it's been retrofitted, but it's that crawler right there that did the job. Get your pictures in on the right side here, even though it's raining. Not good timing right there. Now those black panels on that building are not solar shields. They are windows made out of Kevlar to make them shatterproof. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to tell you how this launch is going to go for Orion. You saw the crawler back there. They've left that the way it is to move those three mobile launch platforms around. But in that BAB is a crawler they've adapted to fit that mobile launcher. Here's how it's going to work. The crawler's going to pick that mobile launcher up, bring it in the BAB, and leave it right there. There, the gigantic cranes in the roof are going to lower the rocket and the Orion capsule on the side of that mobile launcher. And then the crawler will go back in, pick the whole payload up, out this crawlerway 3.5 miles to 39B. The payload will be 18 million pounds. And now you know how the payload will get out to the launch pad. Well, please look to the left, ladies and gentlemen. At 10 o'clock, you'll see the American flag. It's not blowing very well in the rain. However, I'd like you to look to the lower left of that flag, and you will see a big blue box sitting on the ground. Everybody's seen that box on television. That's the famous countdown box that they train the cameras on. That box is over 50 years old. It is so old that when a light goes out, they screw a new light bulb in. To the right of that is the press and media area. This is where they come to cover the launches, 3.5 miles away. Well, now on the vehicle assembly building, a flag on that is 209 feet long by 110 feet wide. Each star, 6 feet across. Each stripe, as wide as my bus. Armored personnel vehicles, that's Orion, that's part of the Orion capsule right there, ladies and gentlemen. That's what it's gonna look like to send the Orion up to, matter of fact, that wasn't there when we came out. Sorry about that. That armored personnel vehicle, they had two of those out at the launch pad during the shuttle program. If they had to abort a launch, the shuttle, the astronauts would zip down a cable in a wicker basket. They would bust through a bunker, and then they'd be whisked off in one of two of those armored personnel vehicles. We're very happy to report that on 135 missions, not one time did they ever have to abort a launch. Well, this just goes to prove, ladies and gentlemen, in Florida, it's raining here and it's not raining over there. So, go figure. Now, if you look over here to the right, the buildings numbered 1 and 2, these are the orbital processing facilities. OPFs, this is where the shuttles would come in after landing and be ready for the next flight. See the blue door on the right? That is home to the X-37B. When you get a chance, Google that. That is a low Earth orbit transport vehicle. That's a spaceship inside that building. And building number 2 is a very highly classified military aircraft. They do not tell us what's in there. And now, ladies and gentlemen, looking to the right at 2 o'clock, you'll see an orange windsock. There it is. To the right of that, the biggest building that you see there is the OPF-3. You just saw that in the film. That's where Boeing has its CST-100. So we have 2 spaceships in 3 of the OPFs. Well, up here on the right, ladies and gentlemen, is a place that we call the gator pit. Sometimes there's alligators, sometimes there's manatees, sometimes there's nothing. We don't stage our animals. Take a look to the right, we'll see if anything's going on today. I don't see anything. Catfish.
Oh my goodness, so amazing. time you had one of those, would you? The Cross. One very, very, very big building we're at. NASA. Space. To the moon. To the moon. I want to go to the moon. Ooh, that's weird. Very hot and humid out here. Very, very, very humid. That's why it's been raining out so much, I can tell. But it's fun. Raining on me. Gosh, rain. Florida weather. Every time I come here, it's raining. Waiting in line now. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left in line. Watching a movie. NASA Space Center! That's what's called. Jefferson Space Center. Just kidding. Packing up everywhere. We're falling down. We got here fast enough. They all stood in quiet. Got back from space. We went on a space mission. We were not allowed to bring cameras, but yeah, we're back from space. Having fun. I'll be in the picture. On the way, I'm really leaving now. Don't cry, John. Don't be like George Clooney.
Still drifting in space.
So we've been finding gators everywhere. Big one, small one, huge one. Huge one. I would not want to go on that walk. They're everywhere.
That was cool.
What did you say?
Dolphins everywhere up there. Whoa. Dolphins.